So hello everyone, this is our next video, IELTS 13 myths busted. So let us see, there are some myths that I come across every day that students ask me about. So I'll also discuss this with you. First thing is, I have heard IDP results are better than British Council results. There is no truth in all these things because these two bodies, IDP and British Council, they are there to conduct exam. So there is no chance that they will have different kinds of results or a variety. And moreover, it's all your preparation. It doesn't matter which center it is. If you are prepared well, you will get through whatever the board is. Then let us come to the next myth. Some centers deliver better results than others. This is a very common thing that is happening, that most of the students will prefer that center, some will prefer that center. Again, there is no such thing like this. The way exam is conducted all over the world is same. The way they are evaluated, the way examiners behave, everything is uniform across the world. So there is no such question that some centers will deliver better results. Even the examiners are also trained properly for evaluating the students. So it should not be thought like this, that there are some centers who give better results. Let us talk about the third myth. Examiners' attitude in IDP is better than British Council. I have seen students saying that in IDP the examiners are more friendly and in British Council they are more strict. There is no such thing like this. Every person has got a different way of speaking. Everyone got a different way of talking with the person. They are trying to be welcoming and friendly with the students. And there is nothing like that. They are there to evaluate your writing. And nothing else they have to do with you. So again, there is no such thing. You should not think like this. Now, one good question I have. Students ask that the articles like a and the, then the words like of, on, in, and the are not counted while writing. This is not at all true. Because if these words are not counted, then you have to write at least 400 to 500 words in task 2 and at least 200 to 250 words in task 1, which is not possible to write 700, 800 words in 60 minutes. So forget this myth that this small words like on, in, and a and the is not counted. Just keep in mind, punctuation marks are not counted. Now, again, the next one. In speaking, people should wear formal clothes. This is a very big myth. In your speaking test, you do not get marks for your dressing, your body language, your eye contact, your hand gestures. These all things are secondary that creates an impression on the examiner. But the criteria of examination is coherence, cohesion, fluency, pronunciation, grammar, and the next thing is vocabulary, the most important thing, the range of words that you have. So that is, these things are judged when you are speaking and not what you are wearing on the day of your exam. Next myth, you should try to speak in English accent to get more marks. Again, there is no such thing like this. Accent cannot be made. It automatically comes while speaking. Especially if you talk about a country like India, here we are popular to speak in neutral accent. We usually do not speak. And if we try to speak like the Americans or the Britishers, it will sound unnatural. And moreover, like just now I told you that you get marks on fluency, pronunciation, coherence, cohesion, and vocabulary. So there is no point of speaking in any accent or deliberately making your speech in some English accent. Now, some of the students say that we just have to fill the pages by 150 and 250 words. Mind this thing, your answer sheet will be judged by two examiners. They read each and every word and they even mark the comments as well. So do not think like this that you have to simply fill the pages. You will be severely paralyzed if you think like that. You have to write each and every word relevantly with the topic. Again, there is one myth. Like students say that high-five words, using a very big words, will fetch you marks in vocabulary. No, lexical resource means that you should be able to use a range of words, different words, and not repetition. Like you are writing beautiful in one place, you can use gorgeous, magnificent, like this. For example, you have to write big, then you can say spacious. So you have to show a range of words and not only the same words like good and nice everywhere. This is the thing, you have to use range, but not, you don't have to use any high-five words. Now, another another myth, important one. Many children say that speaking is a test of our knowledge nowadays because of some questions that you get. Like, just I'm giving you one example. You have to talk about an invention which is useful for the humankind. What it is, who invented it, and what is the application of it in our real life. Now the question is, who invented it? So it's not important, like if I have to talk about telephone, then I should be aware of the person who invented it. I can simply say that, well, I really don't know, to be frank enough, I don't know who was the inventor, but this is very important invention for the mankind. And you have to address the question that you don't know about it, but simply cannot skip it if you don't know. That is the thing. It's not important that you should know, be knowing. Like, one more question they ask, sometimes they ask you, what is the meaning of your name? Maybe you are not knowing the meaning of your name. You can say, well, to be frank enough, I am not aware of the meaning. I'll find it out soon. Okay? One more myth. I've heard that, I've heard students saying that if we get a question of agree or disagree in writing, and if we disagree with something, then we lose marks. It is nothing like that. If you take a partial stand, if you fully agree, if you fully disagree, it doesn't matter. You have to simply justify your stand with proper reasons and examples to support them. There's no point of like this, that agree will get more marks, disagree will get less marks. Now, a general question about IELTS. It is harder than any other tests. If we talk about the other two tests like TOEFL or PTE, all the three tests have four skills they are testing: listening, reading, writing, and speaking. The only difference is IELTS is majorly, it is now pen and paper based. However, soon it will be CBT. And TOEFL and PTE are almost computer based. But there is no such thing. All the three tests have different formats and different things which are evaluated. Different skills are evaluated. Otherwise, ultimately, they test your listening, reading, writing, and speaking skills. It is not that the particular exam is difficult. We have to choose an exam according to the place where we are going. For example, IELTS is called as the universal test. In Australia, IELTS, PT, TOEFL all are accepted. In USA, generally, TOEFL is accepted. So it is the country that you have to select, not the test. Okay. One more thing. Last myth. We should use British spellings in listening, reading, and writing, and not the American spellings. Or the vice versa, we should use American spelling or British spellings. The thing is, anything will do, but you have to be consistent with your format. It should not be like something you have, sometimes you have written some spelling in British language, as a British spelling, and sometimes you have written in American spelling. You have to be thoroughly consistent with your format. And like, as if Indians are concerned, so I suggest that you should use the British spellings because we are aware, we are, our education system is based on the British English. So it is good that if we use a British spelling instead of American spellings. So I hope many of your doubts are clear by now. And keep watching us. Thank you for viewing us. Please like us, share, and subscribe our channel. Thanks for watching, and wait for our next videos. Thank you.